actually, Massachusetts Eye and Ear did studies on eye diseases, specifically the ones I just spoke about, and they looked at dark green leafy vegetables and saw a comparison. They did a study comparing it to Ocuvite, vitamin A, C, D, and E. Guess which one won in terms of eye health? The greens. The dark green leafy vegetables beat out vitamins for overall eye health, for sure. It also shows that it reduces, if we said, heart disease and stroke, death from any cause, lowers our blood pressure, helps us with our weight, and we're gonna hear a little bit more about that, and anti-aging from the inside out. I said she's younger, but really she's not. So,
look good for 80, don't I?
Look good, right, awesome. So that is true. But why not vitamins and supplements? So many of our patients say, but I take a vitamin, or shouldn't I take a vitamin? I always say no, and let me tell you why. What does that mean? You go to the CVS and you see racks and racks and racks of these bottles. But how in the world, what does that all mean? Which one should you take? Maybe you should just buy the whole rack, who knows? Well, the truth is that vitamins, as they are created, they're taking nutrients from food and putting them in a pill or a capsule. So they're, by nature, fragmented substances. And who decided that you should take this nutrient from this food or this nutrient, and that's the one you should have, and believe that it's gonna work like that nutrient would in food? And we know, too, from the research that large doses of individual vitamins can be harmful. There is so much research about that. This is so important that the NIH does a consensus conference every year on a subject of importance to the American people. In 2006, they did it on vitamins and supplements. What they do is they bring in all the researchers, they present the data, and then the board takes that information and comes out with a consensus statement. And when they did it on vitamins and supplements, they basically said that the evidence was insufficient to recommend a multivitamin. And they also said that our assurance on the safety and quality of vitamins was really inadequate. There is a lot of good research in this paper and in this presentation, but it's just out there. You can just look at the research that talks about why vitamins aren't the answer. Two of my recent favorites is the prostate prevention study. We actually at Beaumont, our cancer center participated in it. It looked like a really good study, and was looking at individual vitamin supplementation, specifically selenium and vitamin E. It was also vitamin C, lycopene. But they looked at these individual supplements to see if they could reduce the incidence of prostate cancer. And when they published the first publication in 2009, they found that the supplementation did not reduce the incidence of prostate cancer. Okay, what we call a null study, so it didn't make a difference. But they did a second publication in 2011, and the men who were supplemented, especially with vitamin E and selenium, had an increased incidence of prostate cancer. The same time in 2011, they published a study from the Iowa Women's Health Study looking at women over 65 taking a multivitamin. And those taking the multivitamin had an increased risk of death. And there were certain ones in there, especially iron and calcium, at the doses that they were given in a multivitamin that increased the risk of death. So there are a ton of studies that look at why vitamins aren't the answer. But to me, it doesn't make sense. Why would you take a vitamin pill? That is not nutrition. And vitamins are micronutrients, phytonutrients that come from food. Why would anybody think that a multivitamin would help you prevent disease? So you can't take these nutrients from food and expect them to do what that food does for you. So is this what you want for your nutritional plan? Does that look like exciting and fun? No. The only time that you ever need something like this, if you have a defined vitamin deficiency, and we see that. And we're going to say, yes, if you have a definite vitamin deficiency, we're going to need to treat that because there's some consequences. But we're going to look at that specific medical problem, if you will. Now, all of us here in Michigan are probably D3 deficient. Now, they call it a vitamin, but it's really a hormone. When the sun hits our skin, we get a hormonal change, but it got the name of a vitamin, so there it is. But we don't have sun here in Michigan, so all of us probably have low levels of D3, and that makes a difference in our health. We know in breast cancer, low levels of D3 increase your risk of breast cancer. So we all should have that checked, and perhaps we have to supplement. The only other way that you could do it is stand naked outside 10 minutes every day. Not many of us are going to do that, especially now. So, is this attractive or is this attractive? Much more attractive. So let's talk about a plan that you can put together tonight so that you can give yourself that gift of health. What we learned about in school, and we were talking about what doctors don't know about, what we did learn about is macronutrition. So we learned about proteins, carbohydrates, and fat, and that's important. That's our energy. And so we need that. That's our energy. But what we didn't learn about is micronutrition. We didn't learn about phytonutrients. We didn't learn about micronutrients. We didn't learn about these vitamins, if you will, these elements in plant-based foods that are